Welcome to driver training. Today you'll be taken through the operation of a BR612 diesel multiple unit in DB traffic red livery. During this brief introduction, we'll go through the critical driving controls and passenger operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is where you'll be spending most of your time. Firstly, we need to activate the control desk. This DMU is powered by two Cummins QSK19 diesel hydraulic engines producing 750 horsepower each. The engines need to be started individually and are designated engine 1 and engine 2. When multiple units are connected, their engines are grouped by these designations. To start engine 1, hold the engine 1 start switch in the start position. Repeat this for engine 2. To enable hydraulic transmission, switch the power switch to on. Set the brake key to activate the train brake. The reverser determines the direction of travel. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. The combined power brake handle allows you to control acceleration and braking. To apply power, hold it in the forward position. The handle allows you to apply a specific amount of power. Once you have reached the power you require, letting go will allow it to move back to the hold position. Oh. coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Moving the handle back to the middle will lower the engine power to zero. Keeping to speed limits is important. If you begin overspeeding, apply a small amount of brake by moving the combined power handle into braking and apply braking force in a similar way to applying engine power. We're now approaching the first stop. Apply a small amount of brake force using the combined power handle to achieve a comfortable and safe stop. Proceed to the next stop unguided this time and see how you get on. An emergency brake test will occur during the journey. We will now test the emergency brake and go over the critical steps needed to recover the train. Now that the train has come to a stop, we need to recover it so that we can continue our journey. We can now continue our journey. Good work. That concludes all the basics of operating this train.